Hello students, in this video lecture we are going to discuss public speaking. It is one of the important skills the students need to develop in modern times. Strategies for effective speaking. Oral communication forms a very important part of our daily lives. Whether in formal or informal situations, it is important to learn how to speak effectively. Speaking in a formal environment involves a number of different situations, from presentations, speeches, group discussions, and interviews, to participating in meetings with clients or suppliers. One needs to know how to speak effectively in all such interactions. Here are some key strategies that will help you become an effective speaker. Voice quality is very important. This means that you need to be aware of how your voice sounds when you are speaking to someone. Your voice must be loud enough to be heard, but not so loud that it feels like you are shouting. Regulate your volume and pitch so that it is neither too high nor too low. Remember that everyone should hear you speak, not just the people who are very close to you. Project your voice to the last person in the room. Breath control is also very important. We forget how important it is to breathe when we speak. If we get nervous, we tend to take shorter breaths and so have to pause frequently while speaking, sometimes in the wrong places. Taking deeper breaths not only helps you speak clearly and for a reasonable amount of time, it also helps you regulate your volume better and helps you relax, making for a more effective speaking technique. Clarity is also very important. When you pronounce, you should be very clear. Nervousness or bad habits may make you speak softly or through closed lips or clenched teeth. All these hinder the clarity of speech. Enunciate words clearly. Don't swallow your words or sentences. Another point we have to remember is intonation. Vary your intonation and delivery. When speaking in public, try to convey information with as much vocal energy and enthusiasm as appropriate. Try to make the talk interesting. Emphasize certain words and phrases within the talk to convey their importance and to add variety. Pace is also important. It refers to the speed at which we talk. Keep your pace even so that your audience can understand you without getting bored. Avoid monotony by occasionally varying your pace depending on the context. We need to take proper pauses as well when we speak. Pausing between sentences or important phrases adds impact to your speech. It also helps you control your breath. Pause between sentences or after making an important point. Body language is no doubt very important. This is a very important aspect of being an effective speaker. Though it doesn't involve speaking, the way you position yourself says a lot about you as a person and can impact your effectiveness as a speaker. Having positive, open body language goes a long way in making you an effective speaker. Relaxed hands, firmly planting both feet on the ground, not standing with your weight on one leg or lounging against the wall, a cheerful expression, and simple minimal gestures project confidence and ensure that the audience stays interested. Another important thing is, you know, maintaining friendly eye contact with the audience. The audience must feel that you are speaking to them for a reason. Do not turn your back to the audience or look at the floor or ceiling or out of a window while speaking. Be precise in what you want to say. Do not talk about unrelated matters or anecdotes. Make sure you stick to your topic and present your ideas clearly, accurately, and precisely. Back your opinions with facts when possible. Present your opinions as such and not as facts. Always be polite and respectful to people while talking to them. Do not make biased or politically incorrect jokes or comments. Deal with disagreements in a respectful and polite manner. Listening is basic skill and it is very important. If you want to become a good speaker, you should first become a good listener. You must learn to listen to other people attentively and with respect, and make a genuine effort to understand their points of view. Now we are going to discuss types of speeches. Speeches may broadly be categorized into two major types: expository speech, which describes, defines, or explains a given topic or idea or situation, and argumentative speech is either in favor of or against a given topic and attempts to convince or persuade listeners. Here we are going to discuss expository speech. Expository speech serves to explain something clearly and concisely to the listeners. Here is an example you can see in the picture. It is a picture of a generator, and in the speech, the speaker is explaining how the generator works. The explanation is, the speech is given in the text. The speech I am reading here, concentrate, listen carefully. The teacher is explaining how a generator works. Good morning. In the next few minutes, let me tell you how generators work. A generator is essentially just an electronic motor working in reverse. An electric motor consists of a tight coil of paper wire wrapped around an iron core that's free to rotate at high speed inside a powerful permanent magnet. When you feed electricity into the copper coil, it becomes a temporary electrically powered magnet. In other words, an electromagnet, and generates a magnetic field all around it. The temporary magnetic field pushes against the magnetic field that the permanent magnet creates and forces the coil to rotate. By a bit of clever design, the coil can be made to rotate continuously in the same direction, spinning round and round and powering anything from an electric toothbrush to an electric train. So how is a generator different? Suppose you have an electric toothbrush with a rectangle battery inside. Instead of letting the battery power, the motor that pushes the brush, what if you did the opposite? What if you turned the brush back and forth repeatedly? What you would be doing be manually turning the electric motor's axle. That would make the copper coil inside the motor turn around repeatedly inside its permanent magnet. If you move an electric wire inside a magnetic field, you make electricity flow through the wire. In effect, you generate electricity. Keep turning the toothbrush long enough and in theory, you would generate enough electricity to recharge its battery. That in effect is how a generator works. This was an example of expository speech. Now let's discuss argumentative speech. Let's see what is argumentative speech. An argumentative speech requires a speaker to express whether they are for or against something. Whichever side the speaker chooses, the speaker must attempt to convince the listeners of the merits of his or her argument and try to persuade the listeners to agree with his or her point of view. Any statement that the speaker makes must be backed up with evidence. This will strengthen the overall argument being made by the speaker. The speaker must also take care to respectfully disagree with but not deride those who do not share his or her point of view. Here is an example. In this example, a student is talking about the practice of ragging. He is speaking against the practice of ragging. If we pay attention to the structure of the speech, the topic is mentioned, the speaker's opinion is expressed, and then the speaker offers evidence that justifies his, her, or her point of view. It concludes with an attempt to appeal to the speaker's sense of right and wrong and to persuade them to side with the speaker. Note the use of repetition for emphasis in the speech and how every claim is supported by evidence. The speech starts. Dear friends, I am here to explain my views on ragging. I believe ragging is a menace that is destroying the academic character of many educational institutions. I consider ragging to be inhuman, unnatural, and abusive action which some senior students indulge in so as to terrify freshers or newcomers in educational institutions. The Supreme Court of India defined ragging in 2001 judgment as any disorderly conduct, whether by words spoken or written, or by act which has the effect of teasing, treating, or handling with rudeness any other student, indulging in rowdy or indisciplined activities which cause or is likely to cause annoyance, hardship or psychological harm, or to raise fear or apprehension thereof in a fresher or a junior student, or asking the student to do any act or perform something which such a student will not do in the ordinary course, and which has the effect of causing or generating a sense of shame or embarrassment so as to adversely affect the psyche or psyche of a fresher or a junior student. Psychologically harm, shame and embarrassment, ragging by its own definition, is something that creates a hostile environment. A university is a place of learning and should not be a place where students are filled with intimidation and fear. Such emotions, as the Supreme Court of India says, will affect students adversely. This so-called friendly interaction, as some senior students refer to it, usually crosses its limits and leads to physical aggression and sexual abuse, and sometimes even to death. A report from 2007 by the Indian Anti-Ragging Group, Coalition to Uproot Ragging from Education, analyzed 64 ragging complaints and found that over 60% of these were related to physical ragging and 20% were sexual in nature. The anti-ragging NGO, Society Against Violence in Education, noted 7 reported ragging deaths in the year 2007 alone and 31 reported deaths between the year 2000 and 2007. It is clear from these statistics and ragging that ragging is a very real and dangerous threat that we members and students of an educational institution must take seriously. We must make earnest attempts to eliminate all forms of ragging. Ragging in all its forms must be condemned, as it is responsible for causing serious psychological trauma, which may continue to take its toll through post-traumatic stress disorders, resulting in physical injury and suicide. Though the Supreme Court has passed many strictest rules against ragging, the issue is far from being resolved. This is because many do not perceive ragging as a crime, as ragging is a major cause of campus violence and death. I fervently appeal to all of you to help bring this dangerous phenomenon to an end. In this way, in argumentative speech, you have to support your side, your say, by using evidences, by giving some examples, by giving some data. So for argumentative speech, you should have the ability to persuade the audience to your side. You can do this by studying the topic in detail. So you have to prepare a lot before giving an argumentative speech. Thank you for listening. We are going to stop here.